The U.S. election campaign enters its final stretch. Presidential bets were in the battleground states Thursday to court Latino voters. In Nevada, Vice President Kamala Harris warned voters that her Republican rival Donald Trump would scale back health care programs should he return to the White House. Now, the Democratic nominee also got the endorsement of pop superstar Jennifer Lopez. One of Hollywood's most influential Latinas vouched for Harris's commitment to fight for immigrant families.
With an understanding of our past and a faith in our future, I will be casting my ballot for Kamala Harris for President of the United States proudly.
So, Nevada, to make your right heard and to protect your right to make your own health care decisions, I would also recommend you vote yes on question 6. And make sure you vote up and down the ballot to truly protect your rights. And when Congress passes a bill to restore reproductive freedom nationwide, as President of the United States, I will proudly sign it into law.
Also in Nevada, former President Donald Trump unleashed anti-immigration rhetoric to court voters. He insisted to his supporters that the U.S. has become an occupied country due to illegal immigrants.
They're coming in, and they're by the thousands, and they have equipment that's military-grade equipment. How do they get that? They have military-grade equipment, but it will soon be an occupied country no longer. November 5th, 2024 will be Liberation Day in America. Liberation Day.
With the elections just around the corner, fear of the unknown is what's scaring U.S. voters this Halloween. In Michigan, one of the 7 battleground states, voters are hoping that no matter who wins, Americans could stay united.
I think my biggest fear of this election is going forward, are we going to be united? We're losing our unitedness of the states, and that scares me to death. And I don't care what side you're on, but we all need to come together. And no matter who wins, let's come together. That's my fear. That's a big fear.
Well, the fact that Trump could be elected and just everything that he stands for is like what's scary to me. So.
Harris winning, to be honest, it's just a lot of unknowns. Kind of scary.
The Philippines taking the lead in pushing for the advancement and implementation of the United Nations Women's Peace and Security Agenda. Over 70 member states reaffirmed their commitment to the declaration during a meeting chaired by the Philippines in Manila from October 28 to 30. The declaration is an important follow-through to a UN resolution calling for the prevention of gender-based violence during times of armed conflict. During the same event, the Philippines also secured over 2 billion pesos in foreign aid for women, peace, and security in the Bangsamoro. The funds will be used to address birth mortality, as well as feed children and help farmers in the region. The reported death toll from severe tropical storm Christine and Typhoon Leon climbs to 145. The National Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Council says it has already validated 14 deaths. Over 2 million families, or nearly 8 million individuals, were affected by Christine and Leon. Damage to agriculture is at 4.43 billion pesos, while infrastructure damage was at 6.82 billion pesos. Now, the Social Welfare Department says they have distributed nearly 900,000 food packs across the country as of Thursday evening.
We were able to enter into relief proposition ng agreements with various local government units. Nagamit po nila natin yung kanila po mga warehouses at nakapagpadala nga doon ng mga stockpiles natin. At gayon din po, meron tayong mga existing framework agreements with private manufacturers na kung saan na-complement nila yung isinasagawa natin na production ng mga food packs dito sa ating major hubs.
Meanwhile, the country's Electrification Administration says efforts are underway to restore power in places hit hardest by Christine and Leon. Administrator Antonio Almeida notes power is almost 100% restored in the Bicol region. Now, electrification efforts in Albay City are at 90%, while Batangas province is at 70% due to some accessibility issues. Almeda assures the public power restoration across the country should be complete in a couple of weeks.
Ang ating national government, ultimo ang ating presidente ay nakatutok po sa pagtulong at pag-agarang solusyon sa restoration ng kuryente sa mga lugar na yan.